not going to do that again. I'm not doing that again. I'm not doing that again. Have you ever made the same mistake twice? Have you ever found yourself in the midst of some drama or some mess or some whatever it was that you found yourself in? Have you ever found yourself in the midst of it and you vowed to God that, God, if you get me out of this time, I promise that I'm going to straighten up, I'm going to fly right, I ain't going out again, I ain't going to drink again, I ain't going to do none of that again if you just get me out of this trouble, God. And then he does. He gets you out of it. But then, lo and behold, a few weeks later, a few months later, you find yourself right back in the same mess again. If that's you, guess what? The book of Haggai is for you. In the book of Haggai, God uses his prophet to send a message to a group of folks who were very special to God. He sends a message to them that they needed to hear. Now, this group of folks was the same group of folks who God has sent countless prophets to before to warn them that, hey, look, if y'all don't straighten up, if y'all don't repent, if y'all don't start putting God first, God is going to send y'all into captivity. But they didn't listen at all. Guess what? They messed up. They continued to mess us up. And guess what? God being faithful, he did exactly what he said he was going to do. They went into captivity. But while they was in captivity, though, oh, man. They prayed, God, save us. We're not going to mess up. God, if you just get us through this, if you just get us on the other side of this, God, we promise we will never mess up again. Straighten up, fly right, flushing it down the toilet. We ain't going out. Nothing, God. Well, guess what? Captivity was over. God freed them. And guess what? They slipped back into the same old thing. They started to worship false gods. They started to get lackadaisical. They didn't pray all the time. Things were good. And then God sent Haggai. God sent Haggai to them to remind them that God blesses those who put him first. You see, just like them, sometimes we get our priorities mixed up. We want to be blessed, and then we shout praises to God. But the Bible and Haggai say that God says, put him first, and he will bless you. Well, Haggai told the people that they need to get back to what it was that was important. They need to get back to doing the things that please God, and God would bless them. So like Haggai, if you have messed up more than once, if you went back to the same mess more than once, if you found yourself in a situation that you said you would never go back to, well, know this. You worship a faithful God, you worship a compassionate God, and you worship a forgiving God who simply wants you to put him first, and he will bless you. Amen.